great things come in stacks. Pancakes, decks of cards, and, well, ports on your Cisco device. Why? Well, stacking allows users the ability to expand network capacity without the hassle of managing multiple devices. In other words, stacking makes things simple. In this edition of Tech Talks, we'll show how to stack two SG550 switches and create a link aggregation group. Next. The switches in a stack are connected through stack ports. These stacked switches are then managed together as a single logical device. To start off, we'll plug in our cables. For this example, we'll use SFP ports XG3 and XG4 on both switches. Once our cables have been plugged in, we'll log into the switch. We'll configure the switches in our stack one by one. We'll start by going to the Administration tab and choosing Stack Management. Like we mentioned, we're using two SG550 switches, so we will choose native stacking under the stack mode. We're then going to choose the ports that will be used for stacking. In this example, we are using the XG3 and XG4 ports. For our unit ID, we will choose Unit 1. This will make the current switch the master switch. But before we click Apply, we need to configure our second switch in the stack. We'll start off by logging into the second switch and choosing Stack Management. Again, we'll make sure native stacking is selected and choose ports XG3 and XG4 for stacking. This time, our unit ID will be 2, though, making it our backup switch. We're now ready to click Apply and reboot both switches. The two switches will automatically create a lag between the XG ports we have chosen. And once the switches have been rebooted, we'll be able to manage them both under the IP address of the master switch, Unit 1. Next, we'll go to the Status and Statistics tab and see that our two switches are currently stacked. We can also go to the RAM memory under View Log to see the logs. Here we see the lag that was created with the XG ports. And that's all there is to it. That's how to stack two SG550 switches and create a lag using the stack ports. Thanks for watching Tech Talks from Cisco. We'll see you next time.